What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. There's a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell.
Hi, Barbara.
Hi, lovely girl. Janine Anderson.
And what's your name?
Barbara Perry.
And what's your memory about Lee Meriwether, who we're honoring tonight?
Lee Meriwether. She, no matter what she did, she was always the most beautiful and the best talented and lovely to the other people in the cast. And she was always a star.
Did you work with her?
She was in my play. And she was wonderful in my play. She was wonderful to work with. And she was wonderful about getting older. She seemed to get more beautiful every year. Anyway, love her and adore her. And adore her because she deserves every bit of it.
Hi.
Hi, Lee.
Hi, Lee. Hi, Lee.
Good to see you, Lee.
Good to see you.
We miss you.
And
come and see us.
Come and see us. And come and stay with us for a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have Jack Kutcher.
Hi, my darling Lee. Listen, I've known you for getting close to, I think, 50 years. You were beautiful when I first met you. I remember you from the Miss America contest. I was a young teenager and I saw that. But, you were beautiful when I first met you, and I swear to God you haven't aged. I mean, they say men age more gracefully. If that's true, what the hell happened to me? You're more beautiful, and here I am. What are we going to do, darling? Listen, I've always loved you. I always will love you. You're a kind, wonderful person with a great, great smile. And congratulations on this event.
Hi, this is Elsa Raven, and I worked with Lee Meriwether in a play at Theatre West, and I don't know if you're familiar with the backstage facilities, but everybody in the cast sits at a makeup table that's just one long table with a mirror in front of it. And if you talk to somebody, you look in the mirror because then you can see them four people away from you. And one of the nicest things about being in a play at Theatre West is that backstage chatter. Mm-hmm. And Lee was not talkative, but not quiet either. And if you asked her a question, she'd always answer. And it was just so amazing that sometimes you have to stop and think, I'm sitting here talking to a former Miss America, and she's just like an ordinary other member of my theater group. And that's what she was like. Just no airs, no pomp, just Lee. And a lovely actress and a lovely woman and a lovely family member, I'm sure. And I always got the feeling that she was happily settled at her home. And I was always glad about that. So it was just a pleasure working with former Miss America.
Hi, Lee. It's Naomi. You've known me since it used to be Hirshhorn. But as we know, it's been Naomi Carroll since the 70s. I wrote a letter to you, a love letter, and in it I talked about Spoon River and how we would be at UCLA and in the dressing room and you would do Joyce's hair and we'd all sing. You know, we'd sing, I didn't say what we sang, but you know, we'd sing My Love is a Wanderer and other things like that. And I realized the other day that we finally got to do Spoon River together in 2002 when I understudied whatever her name is, that's terrible, Jane. And I played, you know, I did the songs and the singing and all of that, and you were doing what I call Betty's poems. And so that was kind of wonderful that we finally got to do it when all those years before, you never got, because you understudied all this, you didn't ever get to go on. Anyway, I was thinking, you know, first of all, you and I are probably the only two people left who are still sort of, I'm not really that involved, but I'm semi-involved with Theater West, who are from the original first year. I mean, Joyce is still alive, but she has no interest in it, as you probably know. But I was thinking the other day how you used Theater West the way it should have been used. What was the founder's idea? And that is, you worked on stuff that you might not ever get to do anywhere else. And when you got a job doing something else, you would come in and you would work on it there at Theater West. And you did that forever. I mean, that's the way you always have used Theater West. And during that time, you couldn't be dearer or sweeter or nicer or more loving and caring. And you even cleaned the toilets. Remember that? You cleaned the toilet on Robertson. You cleaned the toilet on Van Nuys. And you definitely cleaned the toilets at 3333. Yes, you're famous for cleaning toilets. Anyway, I love you with all my heart. I truly treasure our friendship more than I can say. And just know I'm sending you big, big hugs and lots of kisses.
The sweet, sweet memories you gave of me. You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Take sweet, sweet one fresh and tender kiss.
The memories you gave.
Add one stolen night of bliss.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
One girl, one boy, some grief, some joy. Memories are made of this.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Don't forget a small moonbeam.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Fold in lightly with a dream.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Your lips and mine, two sips of wine. Memories are made of this.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Then add the wedding bells, the one house where lovers dwell, three little kids for the flavor. Stir carefully through the days, see how the flavor stays. These are the dreams you will savor with
sweet, sweet
his blessings from above.
You can't beat the memories you gave of me.
Serve sweet, sweet it generously with love. One man, one wife, one love, through life, man,
sweet, sweet,
memories are.